Today, we are going to install Redux and use Redux to create a small example. That is, we are going to create a counter element and we will create two buttons and then we are going to see what React does. So, let us go ahead and inside our component folder, we are going to create counter.js. And inside counter.js, this is going to be a class component. So CC or RCE. And now, so let us now go ahead and install Redux. So let me open another terminal. So go ahead and create a new terminal. We will just write npx install redux. Now let us go ahead and import create store from redux at the top. We have added an h1 inside our function and we are going to add two buttons. One will say increment and the other will say decrement. Now I want to add two buttons. One button will say increment and the other button will say decrement. And now if we hit Ctrl S and add this inside our app.js, so our component name is counter. You can see that we have some error inside our counter. As you can see, the red appearance in the name. We are going to import counter. So we are going to complete this function and then we are going to see the output, because now we will get an error. So first I'm going to add the onClick function and I'm going to say this dot increment. This function we are going to write, and for decrement we are going to use this dot in decrement. So let me just copy paste that. Let us go ahead and write our function, that is our reducer function. Reducer, this is going to take the state as input and the state is assigned to an empty array and the action. We have studied about action. Now we are going to add a switch statement. This switch statement is going to take action.type as its parameter type, and then we are going to write the cases. So for case one, the first case is add underscore one. We are going to do the increment. Now inside that we are going to return state dot concat, and inside that we are going to pass incremented one. So this is an array element that will be added inside our empty array as soon as we add this action or we dispatch this action. Second case is, so the next case is subtract one. Subtract underscore one. And again we are going to return a statement. And inside return we are going to say decremented one. At the end, we are going to add our default case. This default case, this is going to return the state. Now let us go ahead. Now we are going to add a let store variable and we are going to call the create store and pass our reducer function inside that. Now we are going to add our const to create our constructor. There will be no props inside our constructor, and note this state. So inside our constructor we are going to call store dot subscribe and we are going to assign it to an arrow function, and we are just going to write a console.log statement first to check and write store dot get state. Now two more things we have to do, that is increment and decrement function. We have to write that. So let's write the increment function is going to say a console.log statement first. So it will say increment action dispatched, and another statement I want is store dot dispatch, and inside that we are going to pass the type of our function, the type is add underscore one. And now for the decrement statement, for the decrement function, we are going to copy it and modify it. This is decrement, and here also we are going to write decrement, and for this add one we are going to replace it by subtract one. So that's it, we are done. After adding our component to app.js, we are getting an error. So we are just going to remove this increment decrement part, and we are going to cut it from there, and we are going to paste it inside after our constructor. So in that way we are not getting an error. And another thing is, for that subscribe we are missing one small bracket, so we will add that, and then you can see that we are getting our counter component. Now let us go ahead in app.js and remove our login component so that we can understand our working of counter.js better. Now let us go ahead and open our console. So let me go to my console, and now I want to refresh the page once, and now you can see after increment I get my console.log statement and my array that has increment 1, and on decrement I have decrement 1. So this goes on adding elements inside my empty array. This is how the counter components work. So that's it for today.